Now, we all know so many things about the Mauryan Empire. But how do we get to know about the Mauryan Empire in such details? So now, there are two sources of history through which we can reconstruct everything that we know today. These are the literary sources and the archaeological sources. We find that in the Minor Rock Edict, Devanampiya Priyadasi had been inscribed. But how do we know that this title was assumed by Ashoka? We get to know it from two types of sources. The sources are literary sources and archaeological sources. So now, as you can see, the first literary sources from which we get to know about the Mauryan Empire is the Indica. Now, what is Indica? Indica is a book that was written by Megasthenes. Now, who was Megasthenes? Megasthenes was the messenger in the court of Chandragupta Maurya. Now, where did he come from? So, Megasthenes came to the court of Chandragupta Maurya as he was sent by Seleucus Nicator. And Seleucus Nicator was the general of Alexander the Great. So, in his book Indica, Megasthenes talked about the situations and the political development during the time of Chandragupta Maurya. Now, another literary source that we know is Arthashastra. Now, what is Arthashastra? It was written in 250 BCE by Chanakya or Kautilya. And Arthashastra is composed of 15 adhikarans. Adhikarans are also chapters. So, this book has 15 chapters. And this book talks about the polity, administration, economy, military structure, and many other aspects of the Mauryan Empire. It also tells us how a government should deal with the empire, how the king should properly govern his entire administration, how should it be. So it serves as a guidebook for the kings on how to govern the empire efficiently. So here you can see the original manuscript of Arthashastra is preserved at Oriental Research Institute. Where is it? It is at present day Mysuru. Now, can you tell me whether this statement is true or false? Arthashastra was written by Megasthenes. Yes, this is false because we already know Arthashastra was written by Chanakya or Kautilya. Now let us come to the archaeological sources. What findings, structures do we find which help us to reconstruct the history of the Mauryan Empire? So there are rocks and pillar edicts. As we have already studied, Ashoka got messages inscribed on the pillars and many rocks which were known as edicts. So here you can see the Ashokan rock edict from Kalsi, Uttarakhand. You can also find the Delhi Topra pillar edict. And you can also see the elephant-shaped edict at Dholi. So these are the places where you find the writings, inscriptions, the messages which Ashoka got engraved on certain pillars and rocks. So what did these pillars and rocks actually have? They had messages from Ashoka to his subjects. They also had the teachings of Dhamma and the royal orders which were inscribed on these pillars and the rocks. Now, what was the language used to get these engraved? So, the language that was used was Prakrit. As you know, that these were the common language of the people at that time. So, these were written in Prakrit language but had different script across the empire. So you see, in the central region, you will find the Brahmi script, and in the northwestern regions, you will find the script to be Kharoshthi, Greek, and Aramaic. So here you can see the Brahmi script inscription on the Sarnath Lion pillar. You can see the Kandahar major rock has the script in Greek, and you can see Ashoka's title Devanampiya Priyadasi in the Lumbini edict. So now you see, this tells us that during the reign of Ashoka, people did not have a single language. So you can see now, you can tell that his empire was expanded over a huge area which had people of different languages and different culture. So Ashoka did not want his teachings to be limited only to the common people. near his kingdom, but he wanted his teachings to be spread. So he used different scripts so that other people in different areas can also understand it better. Now you have learned that there were so many different languages and scripts that were used. Now as you look at this picture, you will find that this has a different kind of script. Normally we today cannot understand this script, but back then this was the script that was used by the people. So who deciphered it? Who decoded it? Let me give you a small hint. The picture that you see here is of a very famous person, after whom a very beautiful colonial structure on the banks of River Hooghly in Kolkata has been named. Can you quickly guess and tell me? Yes, it is James Princip, after whom the Princip Ghat is based in Kolkata on the banks of the River Hooghly. So this was the person, he was the one who decoded this Brahmi script and told that it would further lead to the language that is known today, Devanagari script. So James Princip deciphered the Brahmi script and allow us to actually understand what was written on some of the edict. So this is how we got to know, we got to learn what were actually inscribed on the rocks and the pillars which were known to be edicts. Now people who knew how to read and write would actually understand the messages that were inscribed and engraved on these rocks and pillars. But what about the people who were illiterate? Did not know how to read and write. So for them to ensure that even the illiterate subjects of his empire, they got to know about the message, Ashoka sent his officials so they could read about his messages to the people, to the mass people who did not know how to learn, how to read or to write. So you must have already seen during the political rallies, the parties have a vehicle upon which a loudspeaker is attached and the person uses it to propagate his messages to the common mass. So it is the similar type where such people, such officials used to read it out to them. Now you can see how the edicts were placed during the entire Mauryan time. So you can see it was placed at Kandahar, Shabzgarh, Kalsi, Delhi Topra, Meerut, Lumbini and many more throughout the Indian subcontinent. So now you see, there were so many different kind of sources from which we reconstructed the history of the modern empire, which were based on the literary sources and the archaeological sources. In the literary sources, we saw about Indica and Arthashastra, and from the archaeological sources, we saw about the rock edicts and the pillar edicts, and how the people, illiterate people, got to know about the messages.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon. You can also register for free at DeltaStep.com or download the DeltaStep app and get access to all our 5000 plus amazing videos as per your school syllabus. Master each topic with our adaptive practice technology, get million plus questions with step-by-step solutions and unlimited mock tests. Get all your doubts resolved instantly. Learn via games and win amazing prizes like PlayStations and iPads. So at DeltaStep, learning is not just fun and easy, it is rewarding too. So register for free now.